Hello and thanks for joining us. I'm Paul Lisnick and this is Comcast Newsmakers. This hour's newsmaker is David Scherer. He's the president of the board of directors for the Illinois Education Foundation. Today we're going to be talking about the mission and the goals, the important work of that foundation. David, it's nice to see you.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Paul.
You're also the perfect person to ask because you're the co-founder of the foundation. So let me ask you what the foundation does and what led you to say we need to do this.
Paul, about 5 or 6 years ago, we looked at the landscape and really saw that in Illinois, 65% of our students in college actually go to college at community college. And there was virtually no private sector investment in that space. So we really looked at the landscape and said, let's try to find the students that we can empower to help themselves and help them through not only money, but also giving them the tools through mentoring and tutoring and academic advising.
And that, by the way, the community college student, different, wouldn't you say, in makeup than the typical 4-year college student?
Absolutely. Community college students are traditionally called non-traditional students in the sense that they commute to school, they tend to live at home, and a lot of them are heads of household. They're a lot older than college students who go to 4 years. They tend to be about 27 years of age. A lot of them have their own children, work full-time. So they have much more complicated lives, and that's a lot of what the Illinois Education Foundation is doing.
And they need money, obviously, to do what they're doing. This is a commitment you make for them for their entire educational career at that point. So let me ask you, how do they find you, and what do you require of them?
They find us through both the community colleges themselves. They can access our information at the City Colleges of Chicago website, as well as the CPS website. So we're targeting two different sets of students. Some are right out of high school, 18, 17 years old, and some are 25, 30, 35, even 40 years old. We have a student right now who's 54 years old, and he's going back to learn a trade so he can be employable in his 50s, and that's wonderful. We think that that's something that should be supported.
You want them to be successful, so as I said, it's a financial support, need-based program, but you demand more of them.
We do. There's an accountability component, and we like to think that we give a lot and we also expect results out of our students. Again, we're empowering them to help themselves. So whereas we're giving them scholarships, we're giving them stipends that we defined as living stipends, we're also giving them mentoring and tutoring and academic advising. They have to get a 2.5 GPA in our program to stay in the program. And all the support systems that we have, mentoring, tutoring, et cetera, they have to show up. It's not optional.
So many success stories here. Let me just ask you, we talked about one woman who sort of exemplifies what it's all about. So briefly, just tell me her story.
We have a young lady who has two children, one with special needs, who entered our program 2 years ago. And she wound up starting community colleges, as all of our students do. And she became valedictorian at the community college and moved on to now be a straight-A student at a 4-year college. At the same time, she was both tending for her family and working full-time at night to make sure that they had the money to live on. She's determined to make a better life for her family, and the Illinois Education Foundation facilitates her ability to do that, and she will now, you know, enter the society.
You've helped about 250 students thus far, and as you enter your sixth year, you now have a pretty strong goal that you want to work towards.
We do, and you know, 75% of our students have been successful, meaning they've either graduated and entered the workforce or they've moved on to 4 years. So we've had 250 students to date. 75% have had successful outcomes. We've raised over $4 million to both fund these students and fund new students. So obviously the private sector is responding to a program that they see that has value. But the new goal, and we're going to start it this year, is we're going to add 100 new students a year for the next 5 years. The need out there is huge. And although we've helped 250 students, our eyes are big. We want to help thousands, and we believe that we can.
All right. I believe you can, too, and come back and see me and give us an update.
Thank you, David.
This hour's newsmaker has been David Scherer for the Illinois Education Foundation. I'm Paul Lisnick. You've been watching us here on Comcast Newsmakers. Bye-bye.